This is the biggest cyst that I've ever seen. This is the standing world record of Dr. Pimple Popper's biggest cyst ever.
Okay, this might get wet.
I mean, if you blow a balloon up enough, it's gonna pop. And so I'm just shocked that he has a cyst here that has blown up to this size and the balloon hasn't popped.
That's a cyst, did you see that? All right, we're gonna have to squeeze it. All right, you ready? Get this cyst out of your system here.
Oh God. God.
That is a lot of cyst.
Oh my God.
That's like oatmeal. What is that face for?
I'm just...
What were you doing with the cyst this big?
I don't know.
Walking around with
there?
It? I'm gonna look at oatmeal differently now.
I never really liked oatmeal to begin with.
Finally, you had a baby. It was literally like having a baby. That was the hardest one ever. You know why it sucked? Because I was hurting you. I'm sorry about that.
Don't be sorry. I'm so happy that you did this. All that pressure is off my leg after all this time. I can't believe it.
Wow. You can feel him. He's right on the surface there. All the structures that we're worried about are all deeper. Actually, a lot of them are under muscle. I don't intend to go anywhere under any kind of muscle. But the only issue I have is that if this has been partially removed before,
yeah,
it sometimes there's scar tissue and it's stuck to you. Dripping down, I see it. I think it's like a little eyeball of fat. And how are you doing over there?
I'm good. I'm fine.
Are you sure? Don't fool with me here. This is not the time to fool with me. Okay. You okay?
Yeah. That was just weird. I could feel like.
Need pushing?
No, like my arm.
Or your arm, your nerve, your nerves, right?
Something, yeah, like
triggered, right? Triggered. Because I'm pulling on you. See, it's like really close to
so
your nerves and things
my,
like that.
Yeah, I can tell.
So me going like this, does that?
Yeah.
Right there.
Like I can feel it in the back of my neck.
Oh my God. He's stuck to down deep where there's important nerves and vessels.
Look, he's right there. It just looks so easy.
My shoulder.
See, it's pulling on you, huh?
Yeah.
What does it feel like? It wants to lift your shoulder?
It pulls. Yeah, it feels like a rubber band.
This damn thing. Must be stuck to your nerve down there. This is a bad situation. This lipoma wound around nerves and arteries and veins. I'm closing them up.
All right.
All right, everybody. Sometimes you want something removed, you know, for cosmetic reasons, and it is too much a threat to your life or to, yeah, and we don't want to do that. I wished I could have taken it all, but I didn't want to risk hurting you and, you know, regretting that. We both didn't want to regret that, so I think we're both in that agreement. Yeah. I'm going to give you a hug, because
I'm so... Thank you so much.
Of course. Close your eyes for me, dear. Christy's cyst is the biggest milia that I've ever seen. It's really essentially hanging over her eye, so I'm very careful. Eyelid skin is the thinnest skin on the body, so you can't go very deep. This is also very, very close to a very important structure that I don't want to damage. There's a lot of things that can go wrong here.
We're trying to remove just as little normal skin as possible so we can just get this and pop it out of a little slit here.
And then make sure that like all of it comes out so it won't come
back.
Yeah,
of course. You really think I'm just gonna take part of it? You gotta keep you looking cute. We're getting it, I see it.
Cysts definitely can have funny smells. I mean, I don't react like I smell anything. I definitely don't put my nose down in there and smell it, but they usually smell something along the range of maybe like spoiled cheese or toe jam.
And try to keep all your eyelashes too, because I'm a woman too. I know what eyelashes mean to us.
It's probably hard to do because it looked like it was up against.
Oh, you're right up against your eyelashes, girl. Almost got it. I think I almost got it one piece too. Come on, you're right here. One little number.
Wasn't one spare.
Hold that up there. Yeah. Let's take a look now and see. So now there's a little swelling there, but that is a very superficial abrasion. We just kind of took the very top off of it.
Look at those beautiful eyelashes that were under there. I love procedures like this because they can really change someone's life. They can see it and I can see it instantly. And now she's not gonna have this extra little pinto bean over her eye that is distracting other people's attention.
Do you wanna see what we took off?
Yeah, let's see this
so
thing.
So I think it's just a big million. I don't know, we're gonna find
Jeez
out right
Louise.
Now. All right, in case it squirts. Yeah, you got a cyst there. A cyst on your eyelid. A milia cyst, the biggest milia I've ever seen. That's it, all done. Just like that.
When I look in the mirror, I can see that it's gone.
Look how good she looks. Oh my God, I gotta take a picture.
I feel like I can be the real me. I don't have to hide my face anymore.
You deserve this, you know what I mean? It's such a little thing that I can do.
Since Christy's surgery, she is doing great. Her eyelid is fully healed, and with her newfound confidence, people can finally see the real her and her beautiful blue eyes.
My procedure with Dr. Lee was about a month and a half ago, and I feel like my life has been renewed again. Walking through the aisles of an airplane is an absolute improvement. I don't have to worry about it running into armrests, chairs, people. But after I had the stitches taken out, there was oozing and foulness coming out of the cyst, and I thought to myself, is my leg really healing properly? So I have to get back and see Dr. Lee so she can see it for herself. She's the professional, and she's the doctor, and she's the one who knows.
Well, look who's
Dr.
here!
Dr. Lee!
How are you?
Nice to see you.
Thanks so wonderful
all
to
the way
see
out
you.
Here.
Well, thanks for seeing me again.
It's only been a little over a month, and this looks spectacular. Ronan looks so good. He had the biggest cyst that I've ever seen. And now this scar totally shrunk, like 50% the size. How was it recovering from it?
Well, the day that I took out the stitches, I was in the middle of my sleep. And I woke up and my whole leg was just soaking wet. And I was like, what is that? I turned on the light and the whole bed was blood all over. And that blood didn't stop coming out for 2 weeks.
That actually was a really good thing. That made this heal so much faster, so
right?
much quickly.
Really?
Because otherwise your body has got to slowly like absorb this thing, and that takes a while. Your body was taking care of itself. Were you like, this is why I shouldn't have gotten this done, this is why I, you know?
Well, it was a trust factor. I had to be able to trust somebody, and I really wanted your reassurance that everything was going well with it.
That's really nice. I'm sure all your doctors are going to be Dr. Lee's from now on, right?
They're
all
going to be doctors.
Yes,
hopefully
right.
There aren't any more doctors. Dr. Lee told me that everything is good with my leg. She put my mind at ease about it. There are doctors out there that will do the right thing for you. She is truly my angel.
I adore you.
Thank you.
You're the best.
Thank you.